today, from Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, this is the National Football League. We'll see Ben Roethlisberger and the Pittsburgh Steelers taking on Robert Griffin III and the Baltimore Ravens.
We are at the confluence of the Ohio, Allegheny, and Monongahela Rivers at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, PA. This was the scene just a few moments ago as the Pittsburgh faithful were fired up by the hometown Steelers taking the field. They're all set as they'll match up with the Baltimore Ravens. Two hard-hitting blue-collar franchises, one of the better rivalries going. The Ravens and Steelers are underway. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble, to bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. The Steelers set to go on offense, and it is the big man, Big Ben, number 7, Ben Roethlisberger, ready to lead them.
We talk so often about his physical attributes. Of course, the Big Ben nickname, his ability to take hits in the pocket, his ability to extend plays and get outside of the pocket. But how about this for efficiency? Top 10 in career NFL passer rating. He's one of the top 5 winningest quarterbacks in NFL history. That's pretty darn good.
Now Roethlisberger on first down. And hitting Juju on the slant. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out, and by a few inches, that'll be a first down. Now it's Roethlisberger. And down he goes. A coverage sack. Took too long to get rid of it. Jihad Ward. Give him the credit for the sack and a loss of 14 yards.
There's a little bit of defense right there. Nickel set, 5 defensive backs. They just snuffed out every route that was going. Quarterback never got rid of the football.
So much for coming out throwing, as it leads to an early second down and long. Another try after the first down sack. Roethlisberger, and he's going to go down again.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast, and a big sack. So the sack, and now a third and long situation for the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger. Now Roethlisberger throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And down he'll go at the 25. It's a gain of 6, but not enough, as he'll be forced to punt on their first drive of the game.
How about that strategy there, Brandon? Third down, they just said, we've got faith in our tacklers. We'll give you the short stuff, and just decided to protect the sticks. So every time I hear fans telling me tackling's not a part of the game anymore, plays like that, I can clip and save and show them you have to tackle well if you want to be a good defense.
On fourth down, here comes the Steeler punter, Jordan Berry, to kick it away. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And a fair catch called for and made just inside the 35-yard line. 36 yards on the punt with no return. And out will come the offense as they take over. So here come the Ravens with their first look on offense. And they're led out by their quarterback, the former Baylor Bear. It's RG3.
And what I'm looking for from him today, the things every quarterback is looking to do. Lead his team to a victory. Doesn't matter whether he's throwing it, running it, handing it off, however he has to do it, as well as exhibiting some leadership, that's what he's trying to accomplish.
RG3 going to bring the Ravens up first and 10 at the 34. And from the shotgun, he'll throw. He's going to find his tight end, Boyle. A gain of 6 there on first.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off, okay? So they gave up the completion, but I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication, and as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating, there he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
And he's going to have a Ravens first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Ingram again, a first down carry. And he'll only get a yard, maybe 2, up to the 46.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Throwing on 2nd and 8, Griffin. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down.
Well, that one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
So the failure to connect on 2nd down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Operating from the gun, Griffin. And he's got his target. That's Moore. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. They get 14 on that one. That's good for a Baltimore first down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's 1st and 10, right at the 40. An option run with Ingram. And he'll take this one down to the 36. A gain of 3, 2nd down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up 3 on that carry.
On the option, here's Griffin. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up 3rd down. And not a lot of success to be found there.
Oh, you got that right, partner, because if you're trying to make guys miss about 10 yards or so downfield, that's a pretty good play. But if you've got to do it in your own backfield, I consider that a problem. That doesn't work too well.
Now play number 7 of the drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 10. From the shotgun, Griffin. Eluding the pressure right. He may try and run for this. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. 23 yards on the tuck and run.
That's something you have to be aware of as a defense and have to find a way to account for him. And if you're not going to use a spy, You're telling your guys to keep your eyes on him, because when he breaks out and makes plays like that, all he does is hurt you.
Have to at least be able to contain him somewhat. There they could not. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Out of the gun, they give to Ingram. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
That was a terrific play, causing a loss. As a middle linebacker, simple. You can either fill holes or you can attack them, as he did there.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. They'll run the option left. He will push his way down to about the 14. He'll wind up getting three on the keeper there, but it leads to a third down.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
And Pittsburgh with six defensive backs in the game here on third down. From the gun, Griffin rolling to his right. He can run for it, and he will. So instead of giving them another third down, they'll decline it, brings up four.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really spend a lot of time considering it. Just know that you're probably going to get the ball back. Good job declining that penalty.
So on fourth down, here's the Ravens Pro Bowl kicker, Justin Tucker, out onto the field. Tucker's kick is good. And the Ravens strike first at 3-0. Well, after marching down the field, only getting three there, kind of feels like a win for the defense.
And it does. They'll go to the sideline feeling a lot better that they didn't give up a touchdown after the march against them. But if I were the offense, I wouldn't hang my head over that one. That's a good drive, and 3 points were put on the board.
Tucker now following the made field goal, set to kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. So Pittsburgh retakes the field for their second offensive possession. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Big Ben and the Steelers with a first and 10 at their own 22. First carry for the 2018 Pro Bowler, James Conner. And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27. Calais Campbell on the stop.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Here's Roethlisberger. Open man, completes it to Smith-Schuster. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of eight.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. Setting up the screen, this is Samuels. No gain on the screen there, it's second down. So nothing there on the screen that time.
That means all that great acting they tried on offense went for naught, didn't it? Because you have to try and influence them. Make them think that you're doing something else. Make them think that they can get to the passer by letting them by and then setting up the screen and getting downfield. Didn't happen at all. Give a lot of credit to the defense for not tumbling to that one.
To throw again on second down, Roethlisberger. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. Now it appears we've got an injured Raven down there on the field. We'll check on his status when we get back. Roethlisberger. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that's going to make it fourth down.
Well, the good thing about covering any game I do with you is I know that there's no problem with rhythm. Now, what we're watching offensively, a little bit of a problem there.
Yeah, punt on the first drive, looking at another one here. Just a little slow. It, you know, they were talking about a fast start, but that hasn't been the case.
Yeah, and let's face it, any team we cover always talks about a
fast start. That's true.
But it's not necessarily going to happen just because they say so. And whether it's the script, whether it's, you know, just what they're going through, whether they're seeing different defenses, they're going to have to figure it out as this game moves on.
A 41-yard punt there with no return. Baltimore set to take over here for their second possession of the game. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. RG3 going to bring the Ravens up first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. Out of the gun, he'll throw. And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going down. T.J. Watt, the all-pro, in there to take him down.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Coming up now on a 2nd and 15 following that sack. Another try after the first down sack. Griffin forced out to his left. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's 3rd down. Nothing after one on EA Sports. The Ravens on 3rd down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is going to be 3rd and 13. Operating from the gun, Griffin. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Bud Dupree with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of 7. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
Here's Sam Cook now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10. Pittsburgh set to take over again on offense. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice. So they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
Big Ben and the Steelers with a first and 10 at their own 46. They start the drive with Connor. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
I know we can't hear what's going on in that huddle right now, but I'll guarantee you at least one offensive lineman is saying, my bad, we simply couldn't move him off the line of scrimmage. We've got to do a better job trying to root those guys out of there.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Have to give some credit to the defender on that when he read all of his keys perfectly and got a great break on the ball and able to force that incompletion.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a 3rd and 8. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And that is incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's 4th down.
Well, this first half has not gone according to plan so far, offensively, or even defensively for that matter. They could use a big-time spark somewhere, but it's not going to come on this drive as they have to punt this one away.
Here's Jordan Berry now, as he's on to punt for Pittsburgh. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the 1-yard line.
You rarely call your punter a weapon, but he certainly was there. How about that? Pinning him down at the 1-yard line and helping out the defense in a big way. I'm telling you what, if I'm a defensive coordinator, I might be thinking safety right now.
Coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. They'll run with Ingram here to begin the drive. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves them with 2 to go on second down.
That first down run could not have turned out worse for a defense, because when they came out on the field, their number one mission, keep them stacked up close to their goal line and at worst, create great field position for their offense.
Second down, Ingram. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On the option, it goes to Ingram. Limited running room as he'll get about 3 to the 21.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. Well, let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. 3 3-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on fourth down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
On second and 7, Griffin. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Trying to get it to Willie Snead there. And it's third down. Looked like he had a couple of different options as far as who to throw to on that play. And who am I to say this, but I'm not sure he made the right decision.
Well, the window of opportunity is always going to be small in the NFL. That's why those quarterbacks who make quick decisions and have quick releases have the most success in this league.
On third down, Griffin. Flush to his right. He may try and run for this. 8 yards that time, able to take off, and the result is a first down.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a first down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. From the gun, it's Griffin. That'll be taken in there by Miles Boykin. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
Oh, that was a nice job there. Quarterback and receiver reading the pressure that was brought. They both knew it was going to open up the middle of the field. Nice little shake and bake in the line of scrimmage, got right into his route, and the quarterback hit him in stride, and he was able to run free after the catch.
This is Ingram on first and 10, and he'll get this one across midfield and down into Steeler territory. It was Mike Hilton up to make the tackle. Now flags come in. I think one of the Ravens got going a little early. That's going to set him back 5 yards. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. From the gun, Griffin throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Chris Moore was the intended target, and it's third down. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete. Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. Operating from the gun, Griffin. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. They get 14 on that one. That's good for a Baltimore first down. Griffin going to keep it himself. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because really they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
The throw over the middle, taken in. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
One of the selling points of the in route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success as they did on that play.
The Ravens on third down. They've converted four times out of six. Not bad. Here it's third and three. On third and short, they'll try option left. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. They get 14 on that one. That's good for a Baltimore first down.
It looked like almost a miscommunication defensively because once he decided to keep it, he had pretty smooth sailing.
Yeah, it became a question of, wait a minute, who's got the quarterback? And when you talk about miscommunication, it's supposed to be called assignment football on the defensive side of the ball. But the assignment gets mixed up. That's the end result.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. They'll go with the option coming right. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That'll go as a loss of five. And it'll be a second and long.
I don't think there's any doubt that if it's me, I'd be really cautious about continuing to call this play because you got to know, defenders, if they get a free shot at the QB, they want to take it, and they want to take it big.
And they got it there on the option play for a loss. So after a rare misstep on this drive, they'll try to make amends on second and 15. From the gun, Griffin. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Give him 14 on the play. And that's going to make it third down and less than a yard. Ingram going to get it on the option. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. A 5-yard gain, and now they're set up first and goal.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
Second quarter, 2 minutes remain, 3-0 our score. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half. And this is caught. Touchdown, Baltimore. Willie Snead, there to make the grab. And the Ravens will extend their lead. They went empty backfield, all their weapons out wide, so there really was no secret here to what they were going to do.
No secret, but they still had to execute it, and they still had to protect the guy throwing the ball because oftentimes when you empty the backfield, people bring pressure at you. They managed to hold in there and successfully complete the touchdown pass.
Justin Tucker for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. And what a drive that was. 16 plays all told, and it's capped off by the Baltimore score. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Now White on the return. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Nothing for them yet from an offensive standpoint. Down 10-0 as they come up first and 10. Roethlisberger to the right side to Eric Ebron. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Roethlisberger got to get his guys to the line as quick as he can. Throwing again on second down. Roethlisberger. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate. When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Working with a second and three. Ben to throw again. Trying to get it to Ebron, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 46, and they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line. Well, look, we're watching a quarterback here that's obviously been around for a long time. That's a throw he wishes he had back.
He certainly does, but as you well know, this is a guy that's used to taking a few chances, used to fitting it into tight windows. These are throws that he's made before. Didn't happen to get it completed in this case.
Baltimore with good starting field position as they come up first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 49. After the interception, here's Griffin. And he's going to be swallowed up. Sacked back at the 45-yard line. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Another try after the first down sack. Griffin. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Operating from the gun, Griffin. Man open left side is Brown. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. It'll be a pickup of 14, but they're still a little bit short as it brings up fourth.
And I believe that that gain on third and long changes things quite a bit, because this would be a very long field goal. I wouldn't be surprised to see him go for it here.
Now Justin Tucker. He has hit from 61 in his career, so he has the leg for this. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Tucker now following the made field goal, set to kick it away.
This will make it into the end zone. And no return here for White. It'll be a touchback.
Getting set to go again, Ben Roethlisberger heading back out there. He's got to dig deep here, doesn't he? Team's losing. He's not playing well either.
And they always tell you, don't press. You'll make things a little bit worse. But in this particular situation, you try and heighten your play a little bit. So far, he's thrown one interception. He wants to balance that off with at least one touchdown pass in order to get his team back moving forward.
Here we go. Block 80. Let's go deep. Key tight end. Four down. Check.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Short little throw to Ebron. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
The completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
Roethlisberger got to get his guys to the line as quick as he can. Final play of the half. It's Roethlisberger. He'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete. So we've reached the intermission in what right now is a 13-point game. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome, everyone, to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. We saw a strong first half from our quarterback. His guys have the lead, as we'll hand it back over to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Ravens ready to receive it, and they've got the lead as well as we resume play in the second half. The return man is Hill. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Players spotlight time now. Robert Griffin III. And maybe he's starting to wave the white flag a little bit. He's playing pretty well, but the pressure, it's got to him.
Has to find a way to step around it, step through it, or just handle it. Because as you mentioned, he's having a pretty good day overall. Just the hits keep coming and taking those sacks. That's not the way that they want to finish a ball game with their quarterback on the ground so much.
He'd like to stay upright. When he's been upright, he's been pretty good. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. Come on. Again, they'll run with Ingram. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3.
But when you go from 2nd and 4 to 3rd and 3, that just tells you who won that battle on the last play, huh?
Yeah, first round went to the offense, 2nd round the defense. On 3rd down, Mark Ingram, and he's going to have the 1st down at about the 38. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, 3 plays, all 3 short runs, but together a 1st down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. The play fake. Here's Griffin. And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going to go down. T.J. Watt able to get in there for his 2nd sack of the afternoon.
They need to stop to get back into this game, and here's one right to start the 3rd quarter.
Yeah, anytime you go into the lockers with that 2-3 score deficit, you're right. You need that stop, get the football back, and they've done just that.
Series to series, play to play.
Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's 2nd and 15. From the gun, it's a run for Ingram. And he'll work this one up to about the 38.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
To throw on 3rd down. Griffin, he's going deep for Brown. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Here's Sam Cook now, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. His 1st punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. Time for the Steelers offense now to get set for their 1st possession of half number 2. And Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the 1st half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try and get some points.
Big Ben and the Steelers with a 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line. He'll start the drive with a give to Connor. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
On 2nd and 9, Roethlisberger, short little throw to Ebron, and he gets it here to right around the 24 before he's out of bounds. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. Short little throw to Ebron. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. Here's Jordan Berry now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. Fair catch called for and made, but now we'll have to see about the penalty.
Hey, we don't need no more penalties right here.
This is one of the dangers of going for the punt block.
And you know before you even call going for the block, it's a risk-reward play. So many factors come into it. They went after it, and you know punters, what they do? They leave their leg up in the air an extra count or two, hoping someone comes into contact.
Now it's first and 10 after a costly penalty there on fourth down. Now Ben going to give this one to Connor, and he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I see a shake of the head as he gets up, and you've got to imagine he's thinking, guys, you got to help me out. He's hoping his team can read his thoughts, because he definitely needs some assistance.
And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. Only a yard there on the keeper, and that's going to leave him with a third down. Roethlisberger will throw. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Well, it looks like they got what they wanted. They got the completion, but they weren't able to break any tackles or gain nearly enough yardage to pick up the first down. Now to be fourth and short.
Here's Jordan Berry now, as he's on to punt for Pittsburgh. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. And now here come the Ravens. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and give these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. RG3 going to bring the Ravens up first and 10 at their own 23. An option run with Ingram. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
On 2nd and 7, Griffin. That's into the hands of the tight end, Boyle. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. On the option, here's Griffin.
6 yards there on the keeper. It's second down.
Well, that's what he can do, you know, when he keeps the football. It's not a huge gain, but it shows how hard it can be to stop him.
Yeah, and I thought the defense had that one pretty well contained, and in fact, they probably came up and felt pretty good about what they did. Then they looked up and realized he still got good yardage out of it. He's a tough guy to stop.
On second down now, it's Ingram. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Midfield now. Here's Griffin.
Now look out. Griffin hit and he lost the football. It's loose.
But it looked like a Raven was able to get in there and they will indeed keep the possession.
When that ball popped free, we could hear it all the way up here. Those guys down on the field alerting everyone to the fumble. He's lucky that his offensive mates picked him up and jumped on it.
Yeah, and you have to think to yourself, and I'm sure they've been echoing it on the sideline and into the huddle. Guys, we have the lead. Just take care of the football. Don't make it easier for them to start to make a comeback.
So they keep the football, but now face second and long.
Now Ingram, he's been busy today.
Call it a 3-yard gain, but they'll be forced into a 3rd and 15 coming up.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game, and while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
Third and long, it's Griffin. And that one drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
Here's Sam Cook now, as he's on to punt for Baltimore.
Yards on the punt with no return, and the Steelers are going to take over 1st and 10 deep in their own territory. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field.
And here we are almost through 3 quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Big Ben and the Steelers with a 1st and 10 at their own 14-yard line.
He'll set up to throw from the gun.
Ebron with it over the middle.
And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. Roethlisberger will hand to Connor. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up 1st and 10.
Now Roethlisberger to throw, and his throw's going to be incomplete.
fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
Second and 10, it's Roethlisberger once more. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. On third down, Roethlisberger. Ebron caught left side. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Barry on to punt as he gets this one away. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. And the Ravens, they'll take over. Robert Griffin III now gears up to lead this offense again. He's been pretty solid, pretty consistent, just the one touchdown pass, but I think he's managed the game well, no?
I would agree with you, and that's what you're looking for out of your field leader, making sure that you're playing well and not making any big mistakes. Oftentimes, that's how you're judged. Mm-hmm. How big a mistake and when it occurs. No interceptions so far. They'll like that.
I just want you to know that you agreeing with me, that's going to get me through this third and fourth quarter. Are you touched? He's patting his heart, boys and girls. He's touched.
Respect.
And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. It's Big Vince Williams who made the tackle. Is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Out of the gun, Griffin over the middle into traffic, and that's complete. And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. It's a first down on a gain of 10. Griffin going to keep it himself. Shreds the tackle. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A big-time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. First down.
So this play, you know, until recently, only something you'd probably expect to see in a college game, but running quarterbacks are certainly in vogue, and this turned into a big play.
And you and I both know that for a long time, coaches worried about their quarterbacks taking too much punishment running plays like this, and they still worry about it. But when you can break up big chunks of yardage like that, it's worth the risk. Plus, you're coaching that quarterback to see those guys coming and get down before the big hit occurs.
They'll throw on first down with Griffin. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds.
Now, that's the type of play that gives you a chance to win. Nothing forced downfield where you don't have a guy open. Swing it out to the back, and maybe even check it down, whatever you want to call it. Gain of five. You're just trying to get four on first down. They're ahead of the chains now.
And they run the option on second down.
Now look out. Griffin hit, and he lost the football. It's loose. And it's picked up by the Steelers. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
Partner, that one looked like it was over. I mean, they had control, had the football, and the defense had to make a play in order to keep them in the game. That's exactly what they did.
And now that door ajar, two-score game, so hold on here, not done in the fourth. Big Ben and the Steelers with a first and 10 right at the 30. Following the fumble recovery, it's Roethlisberger. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. That catch good for only a couple. Fourth quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second one to even matter.
Looking to throw again on second down. Roethlisberger. Johnson with a completion over the middle. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it. Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. Throwing again, it's Roethlisberger. Open man completes it to Smith-Schuster. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. Even though this offense doesn't have a single point to its name, they're not totally out of this game yet. A touchdown here, they could be in business.
And how about that last play? Now they've got momentum going, so you know I'm a big advocate. Get back on the line of scrimmage, throw another play at them while you've got them rocked on their heels.
So the ball moves from their own 41 to the other 41 here for first and 10. Again, it's Roethlisberger. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
We always hear from coaches how much they like to run crossing routes because they want to hit their receivers on the go, get them the ball, and keep them moving. How about when you hit a tight end that way? Okay, the receivers are going to run past you most of the time. The tight end, they can do their damage a different way, break a few tackles, and really scatter some people, can't they?
To throw again on second down, Roethlisberger, and it's complete. He gets this one to Washington. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 15-yard line.
Good yardage on the completion there, and when they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
Finally, a first red zone opportunity for these guys. They've got a first and 10 at the 15. To throw again is Roethlisberger. That one into the hands of his tailback, Samuels. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Give him 6 on the play, and it'll make it second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
On second down, Connor looking for space. And once again, they stop him behind the line. Great job by this Ravens defense. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
And the Steelers on third down, they're struggling. 0 for 6 thus far. This will be third and 6. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers.
Deontay Johnson on the other end of the throw from Ben Roethlisberger.
And the Steelers are able to make this a close game again.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you've got out wide and who you're going to throw it to. Give him an opportunity to go up and make a play, even when contested. Looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor, in effect.
Chris Boswell now for the extra point. And that'll make it 13-7. That time, a 9-play drive. And it ends with the Steelers finding the end zone. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. They've been asleep for a little while on this side of the football, Charles, and the score is just a 1-score game now. Haven't had any points this half. What gives?
Let's go old school here. All right, let's get back to the basics. Get back to running the football, high percentage throws. Find the guys that eat pressure and make plays for you and make sure they touch it.
RG3 going to bring the Ravens up first and 10 at their own 26.
On the option, it goes to Ingram.
And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And all of a sudden here, it's third down.
And they have just not been able to block him at all throughout this game. Seems like every other play, he's doing something in the backfield. Already got 2 sacks. And now here's a tackle behind the line.
Third down, Griffin. And that will be incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Here's Sam Cook now as he's on to punt for Baltimore. Good head down running on the return. Gets about 15 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Getting set to go again, Ben Roethlisberger marches onto the field. And those numbers, they kind of tell the story of his game so far. Started off not so hot. Now he's really heated up.
And remember, he signed up for duty as the guy who leads the team, right? The field general, the signal caller. So when things go rocky early, he can't just exit out and ask someone else to pick things up. He's got to do it himself, and that's what he's done here in this game.
And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes.
Calais Campbell.
Give him the credit for the sack and a loss of 14 yards. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. Another try after the first down sack. Roethlisberger. Eric Ebron, the big tight end, his intended target. Third down here. You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his feet. Well, yeah, for whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Well, but you're good at it.
Well, I try, all right? I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to tell. His mechanics are off a little bit, exactly what you described. Footwork, that led to the incompletion.
And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. That'll bring up fourth down. They wind up getting 8 yards, but they needed more than that.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
Here's Jordan Berry now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Yards on the return following a punt of 41. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
RG3 going to bring the Ravens up first and 10 at their own 21. Ingram going to get it on the option. And he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8. You know, I was going to ask you if maybe they should surprise and pass the ball, but where they're at on the field, I think keep it on the ground, right?
I like where you're going with this one because field position is going to determine these play calls. And backed up where they are, I don't even think about putting the ball in the air. I tell my running backs, grasp the football, and I tell my offensive line, don't allow any leaks.
And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They're facing a critical third down now as they try to hold on to this lead. And this will not get close to the first down marker as he's brought down at the 26. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. Here's Sam Cook now as he's on for the fifth time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Well, a solid punt, but also a nice return there of 14 yards. So Big Ben and the Steelers now down 13-7. A minute 44 to go. They need a touchdown. A field goal is worthless now as they come up on first and 10. Roethlisberger setting up the screen. This is Samuels, and this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of 4.
Go,
Roethlisberger got to get his guys to the line as quick as he can. Roethlisberger to throw. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now it's Roethlisberger, and that is incomplete.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
So down six, and they know they need this one on fourth down. They're going on fourth down. It's Roethlisberger. And that's caught inside the 35. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down. Well, they did the part they had to do. Quick throw, got the first down.
But that doesn't allow them to relax. They still have plenty of work to do.
One crisis averted, but they still need to move hastily. Back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that's going to be too high, out of bounds and incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10. Throwing now is Roethlisberger. Short little throw to Ebron. Stops short of the 25, but that second effort got him a couple extra. That'll leave them with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Back to throw. Able to find Switzer. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ballgame. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Nowhere to turn this time, and he goes down. Sacked back at the 29. And with just inside of 10 seconds to go, they'll burn their final timeout. 9 seconds left. Well, they're in some hot water now. After that sack, it's second and 21. He'll look to throw. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down. Well, Charles, they were close in the end, but they couldn't get that last play, that last little miracle play done. They were within striking distance, but couldn't find a way to score.
They definitely had hope. They definitely had opportunity, just unable to cash in at the end. Not an easy play by any stretch, but they definitely had a chance.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. With that, we sign off from Heinz Field.